Okay, guys, next is the fueling. Okay, so this is our fogger installed, this is nitrous line installed, as I told. Let's go. So this is the fuel line. So we will connect the other end to the fuel solenoid. This is written fuel. Okay, so as I told you, these fittings are AN3. So on the one side we will fit the AN3 fitting. Okay, this is in and this is out. So on the outside we will fit the AN3 fitting. Here's the AN3 fitting. Okay, here it is. Or dash AN into 1/8. Okay, so we will extract dash AN fitting. And let's see. This is the fuel solenoid. So on the out, we will type this. As I told you, you can use the epoxy or JB Weld or liquid Teflon over here, but not on this side, okay? Because these fittings will be tied once, but this fitting we will be opening to change the jets, etc. Okay, so let's suppose I have tightened this. Now on this side, that's the tricky part. Okay, now that depends on which fuel system are you using and which further fuel fittings you want to use. There are two systems used. One are the bar fittings and other are the dash AN fittings. Okay, so the NX sends the bar fitting for this end. Okay, so this is the fitting which NX sent, and this is their rubber pipe which is supposed to carry the fuel. And look at that, this is the minimum standard which should be used for the fuel, SAE J30R7. Okay, so this will not melt internally due to the fuel gasoline. Okay, so this is the one you are looking for. At least this is the least standard. Okay, now there are R8, R9, even R14. Okay, so NS just send this, just this almost 1 foot length. Okay, so on other side there are various options. We have this NPT 1.82 bar. Okay, so as I told you earlier, this is the bar fitting on which you can put this hole and then use a clamp to tight it. Okay, but these are the AN fittings. Okay, you just tighten them, no need to use any clamp, any sealant, etc. Okay, so we are using the bar fitting. So these are the fitting which were remnants of my old fuel pressure regulator. So I have many options, the 90 degree, the straight, etc. You will choose what your car engine bay decides. Okay, let's me put this, let's go 30 degree. Okay, so I have put this 30 degree bar, tightened it. Okay, now on other side I have put this. Now another important thing is NX sends these type of clamps. I'm not fan of these. You should use these type of clamps. Okay, these are fuel injection clamps. Look at the difference between the two. Okay, so if you don't know the name, just take a picture and ask your shopkeeper you want to buy this. Some are small, some are big. So I will be using this one. This is 8 13 to 15 mm, and this small one is 8 to 10 mm. So it's easy, just clamp it and tighten it with screwdriver. So let's move forward. Now how to connect the other end to our fuel system, that's the tricky part. Okay, there are various options. Now this car is using the AN system. Okay, and I converted into the AN system. So the my option is this one. My car is now using dash AN6. So this is an adapter. This is dash 6, AN6 to AN6. Okay, so on one end I open it, just clamp my car system. On other end, and these are the gauge ports. I can put a fuel gauge over here, or I can don't use this port and just put another bar clip here. Okay, so now the other part of the clamp I use this one. So now we have connection to our fuel solenoid. So this is the easiest way, but most cars don't have AN line systems. So most cars have the conventional system, which I am going to show you now. what this car was previously using. So this is the old fuel rail, okay, the K series fuel rail. So this was using this type of fuel fitting, okay, this one. Just push it here and just press it, it tightens over there, okay. So the NX makes an adapter. This is the part number. I'll also show to the links. And first we need to remove this in this plastic, then this just clamps over here, okay. Just push it and it will be tight, okay. And your fuel rail, your fuel adapter, this this white part will bolt on over this, and this will clamp over this, okay. So now we have two ports. One we can use the bar fitting and any bar fitting, and we can apply our rubber hose over it, and you can clamp block it with the blocking screw, okay, if you want, okay. Or if you want, like I will want to add a fuel pressure safety switch, okay. This is very important if you are using a NOS, because if your fuel pressure drops for some reason, this is the safety switch. If the fuel drops below than 35 psi, here it is mentioned on this, okay. So this is 35 psi. So if the fuel pressure drops than this, the NAS, it will cut out the NAS output, okay. I will show you in the wiring how do we wire it if you are using a safety switch, okay. Here's the part number. So this was the second option. If you don't have this, then there is a third option, okay. So this was the part which was just connecting from my fuel rail, and there is another connection. So I did not want to cut this part, okay. So I went to the junkyard and just found a similar one. Now you can cut it with a plas or any cutter, and then you can use any, just like this T, okay, the barb T. One end will go here, one end will go here, and then you will attach your this part, okay, this part over here, rubber part, okay. So now you have connection to your fuel solenoid. So this is the third option. So okay, so what if you are having a kit which does not come with this standard pipe, the J30R7, okay. For example, you are in India, Pakistan, etc. So what I found which worked the best is these nylon pipes, okay. These are easily available locally, and this is a very small one, just a 3 mm. We will be not using them, so we will be using the 5 mm one, okay. The big one is 6 mm one. This one is very wide inside, we will not be using. And this one, this is ideal, this is 5 mm, and this is different color but same thing, okay. So this is the pipe we can use easily. So but this will not go easy on this, okay. So what will be do it, as you are dealing with a fuel system, so the use of lighter is not recommended. So either you will use the heat gun, or you will just boil water in a cup or anything, just dip the end in that cup and it will soften. So just it will take some force, but when once it is clamped, just use fuel injection clamp. So these are the three options. First was the AN9, second was this one, and third is the nylon one, okay. Okay guys, so the main part, as you know, we passed one wire, or if you want your and purge, then you will pass the two wires, okay. So we passed a wire all the way to the let's suppose to the engine compartment. And if your car has the fuse box inside, like most modern cars have, okay, like I have fuse box right here, okay. So maybe some cars have fuse box in the engine bay, so that's it, you can take power from that. And we need to take a switched power source, okay, the ignition. When you turn on the ignition, then whichever fuse, whichever wire has power, we will take that wire, okay? And that's very handy. These are called tap a circuit or add a circuit, okay? So what we will do is, we will just put our wire inside, just crimp it, and the other end we will just remove that fuse, okay? And please remember that fuse, the power you are taking should not be something very important, for example like airbag or like ABS, etc, okay? So you can take from the dim lights or the radio, so the less important thing, so that if something goes wrong, then there won't be a large problem, okay? So once you have decided what fuse you will taking out and putting this thing inside, okay? So let's suppose we have attached a wire to this and then crimped it, and then you will just remove that fuse and put this thing instead of that. And this first position is for the car original fuse. Whatever, for example, if you remove the 7.5 ampere fuse, you will put that fuse here. And I think for our nitrous, this is just to trigger the relay, okay? This should not be so powerful. So a 7.5 will be enough, okay, for this. So you can put whatever the car is using here, and for nitrous trigger 7.5 will be enough.
So let's discuss the main wiring diagram. This is simple. As we have taken the 12 volt switch from ignition source, then we will add an on off button. Like I have this toggle switch, you can take any on off button of your choice. These come in two legs or three legs. These three legs or three prong have the LED feature. At night you will be seeing this. Similarly, this come with an NX, and this came with my purge switch. This has small LED, and this is also a three prong, okay? So the wiring is simple. On this side you will attach one wire, on other you will attach the ground, and then the power source will be going through that. So this is just to arm the whole system, okay? Nitrous system. When you press it on, then the whole system will be armed, okay? Or it will be ready to go. Then there will be coming that small, this is our on off button, okay? You have many choices, whatever you want to add. Then is that famous small red button of the nitrous. Where it is? Here it is. This came with my NX kit, okay? That little button. Or this can be, this came with my purge kit, so this can be this. And then you can fit it with the steering, with any of the clamps of your choice, okay? You can be creative here, whatever, wherever you want to mount it, okay? So that will be our the main nitrous activation button, okay? The first on off button will arm the whole system. The second one will just on off for the nitrous button, and that is usually with a flexible wire, because when we steer the steering wheel, the wire will all tangle up, okay? So I use this telephone wire, and because the wire does not come with your NX kits, so this is flexible telephone wire. You can attach it here, okay? So next, the other one end of that is, this is our on off switch, and this is our nitrous activation button, okay? And the third is, you can pass now this attach this wire to that button, okay? So the wiring will be complete. But if you want to add an extra safety, okay, like you have the software K Pro, or you have other options, okay, so you can add them here now, okay? That I have written, that K Pro or the East, that you can add here for the extra safety, okay? Or you can use this the nitrous outlets safety switch, or other companies, okay, that also have safety features like RPM switch light, because nitrous should not be activated on low RPM if your engine is stock, okay? That is very hard for the connecting rods, okay? The connecting rod may break, okay? So below 3000-4000 RPM you will not activate the nitrous, okay? And also on red line you should also not activate nitrous. So these switches just have safety features, okay? So then the wire will be going to our outer relay, okay? That I will cover it. So this is simple. On off button, then push button, then directly to outer relay, or you can add a safety feature here, okay? So now we will go out.
Okay guys, so the last step is adding a relay. So that is very easy. This is the main diagram we will be using. We will be using 4 pin relay, not the 5 pin. It is very simple to use. Let me show you. This is the 4 pin relay from the NX, okay. They don't supply it with a kit. I personally imported it, made in USA, okay, but costed me around $42. It is clearly labeled here 3087. This is actually the 5-pin relay, but we will be using it as a 4-pin relay. We will be not using the 87.A. 87A we will be not be using, okay. So we can use it as a 4-pin relay. Let me show you how. Okay, first of all, battery positive, we will use a fuse. Any inline fuse will work. The solenoid usually draw, the nitro solenoid usually draws around 15 to 20 amperes, and some bigger one use 30 amperes. So, and the fuel solenoid draws very little current, like maximum 5 amperes. So the total I am using is 25 ampere. That's enough for me. So first, I will connect this with these terminals. Any of the terminals I will be using. One end of the terminal will be with this fuse. Okay, this will be connected to my battery. I have removed this red cover over the battery. So here you can see all these screws exposed. So I will open one up and just install this one here and again tighten the screw. Okay, so our battery 12 volts to the fuse are complete. Now we will attach the other part to the 30 part of the relay. Okay, where is 30? We will see. Here it is, it's 30. Okay, so which wire is black wire? Black wire is going from 30. So the other end of the fuse will be with this black wire. Then will be 85 will be ground. We will see which is 85. This white one is 85. Okay, this will be attach another terminal with it and ground it with any of the bolt of the car. So that will be our ground to the relay. Then here is the 86. 86 is that green wire which I told you which was coming out from my car. Okay, the wire you passed with your main nitrous line which was coming out from the hole in the firewall. Okay, so you will attach that wire to the 86. And the 87, this is the one which will activate your nitrous solenoid. In this case, this is the this green one. So what you will do, one wire of the most important step is you will wire both solenoid with same relay. Okay, if you are using two relays and your bad luck the fuel relays fail and nitrous keep coming, your engine will be blown. So always use one relay to control both of the solenoids. Okay, so we will take one wire, both relays one wire, and attach it to the R87 or the green wire, and the other two wires will be grounded. Okay, so I will take the other two wires of the solenoids. In this case both color is blue, in this case both is red. So I will attach these two, join these two together and put a terminal over them and ground it to any of the screws. So our wiring of the relays will be complete. Now when we will push that button of the NAS, then circuit will be complete. This is a small electromagnet which is energized that pulls this pin here, and circuit will be complete. So power from the 86 will transfer to the 87. Another thing, if these relays are too expensive, the next one you can use the relays from the older cars. This is very thick and heavy relay. This was the Toyota relay, okay. Denso Japan, and this one is made in USA. This one I got in cheap, simple to wire. This is ground, this is your signal wire, this is your output, and this is your battery in. So simple to wire, and these are cheap alternative if you like. Then there are China ones, not so good quality. I got them 10 in like $20. So these are labeled as 30-40 ampere, and